Hey everybody, welcome back to Gamer Sanctuary. It's Sunday afternoon, it's the 40K League Day. Just get a quick pan, see all the people getting their stuff out and get ready to play. It's pretty cool to see 40K alive and well here at Gamer Sanctuary. We haven't been able to get over here all that much just because, you know, life happens when you're when you've got jobs and kids and stuff like that. So, yeah, it's been a lot harder for us to participate or host things like this. But Brian and I were able to get the day free to do some more Adepticon practice, so we are breaking out our big list for the third day of the Horus Heresy Narrative. 2150 points. Now, we both have Loyalist forces because that's what we're both playing at Adepticon, but you know what? Today, these guys are just a little bit confused, and they've forgotten how they feel about the Emperor. So, we're going to be taking on Raven Guard versus Solar Auxilia, 2150 points. Let's take a look and see what I'm bringing for my practice list today. Now, I still have some stuff I'm waiting for before I finalize my list. I've got a couple things that are in shipment right now. But this is what I have just for today to practice with. It's being led by Corvus Corax himself, fully equipped. He is not his wounded version like the last time I used him, which was a lot of fun, thematic for our narrative event at the Michigan GT. But for the Horus Heresy stuff at Adepticon, he'll be fresh and ready to go. Now, this is the only round we can actually use Lords of War and Primarchs and stuff in, so I figured why not bring him. I also have Strike Captain Mon. He's going to be in a drop pod with five plasma gunners. They are the tactical support squad over here in a drop pod. I've got a tactical... I'm sorry. There's a tactical squad right there with just a Vexilla, just because I had 10 points. They're also in a drop pod as well. I have an assault squad with two plasma guns and Raven Talons and Melta Bombs and the Sergeant, just to round out my troop choices. A Whirlwind Scorpius. I have two Deathwind drop pods here. One right here has crack missiles and drop pod assault, and the one here is just standard frag. And then to finish off the list, I have, in my elite slot, I have 10 more Deathwing with Combi Meltas and a Rhino and a Xiphon Interceptor. So that's 2150 points of my Raven Guard. Oh, and I'm running Decapitation Strike as usual. Here we have Brian's 2150 points of Solar Auxilia. They are led by Lord Marshal Massad. This is the guy who basically gives hatred traitor to his entire army. Now, because we're both Wayne Loyalists, we're going to play it that he has hatred Loyalists instead, because I won't be a traitor. I've got Corax. I mean, come on. Corax is a good guy. He also allows one of the first unit that is destroyed on his side to come back on a 5+. Typically, it's one of the super heavy vehicles, which is really terrible, and Brian never seems to fail that role. So hopefully we can break that trend. Lots of troops. There's a 10-man power axe section. Is it 10? 2, 4, 6, 8? Yep. 10 guys with power axes. There are troops, not the elite choices, so they actually score. They don't have weapon skill 5. There's a 20-man las rifle selection. 2 10-man storm sections with the Volkite weapons, and they're both in the Dracosians with Ceramite on those, or is it Flare Shields?
Flare shields
on these, and Ceramite on the tanks.
And the cannon.
Yep, and Demolisher cannons on all those.
This is a Malkador heavy tank today.
Yep. This is the only proxy in Brian's list because it's still being painted. He's got a Malkador heavy tank. The Dracosian is the same footprint. It's just, imagine a little turret on front. We were actually joking about putting a Layman Rust turret on there just so we don't forget. And then the Infernus, which is just terrible. I hate that thing. And then the Valdor, which is something I haven't seen before from Brian. Fortunately, I don't have a whole lot of armor to worry about that, though, so it's not going to really impact me, but that stupid thing has got to go. And finally, to round it off, we have 3 Rapier multi-lasers. These are the cheap twin-link streak-six shots, good for scattering light armor into the wind. 2150 points. We're going to roll up a random mission and deployment from the Age of Darkness book. We are going to use some of the special rules that have been released from the Adepticon event. Most of them are campaign-oriented for this round, so we really can't do anything with them yet. But we can use the special artillery dice that you saw in the last bat rep as well, which was an awful lot of fun. So we're going to go into deployment mission coming up. So here we are after deployment. Scout moves, infiltrate, and seize all that jazz. We forgot a few things, so we had to reshoot this. We are playing Search and Destroy deployment, which is table quarters with a bubble in the middle. And Shadow Strike is the mission, so we're trying to get scoring units into each other's deployment zones.
I deployed first. I won the roll, and I have my assault marines hiding behind the crates here. Korax, I'm going to try running him by himself so that Brian has to snap fire against him. My Scorpius is tucked back in the corner like he should be. My Rhino was right there, and I'll tell you why he moved back in a minute. Two Dracosians full of stormtroopers right there. The big line of lads guns kind of bubble wrapping all three of the super heavies. We've got the Infernus, the Valdor, and the Malkador right here. Those two flip-flopped as part of Brian's warlord trait to change his deployment. The rapiers are here and the axes are here. Now, what we messed up was doing scout moves and stuff after Seas, because that's part of the FAQ. So that technically happens at the same time as scout, so we rolled off to see who went first. Brian actually got to do that first, and I got to do the scout, but we forgot to roll the Seas roll, so we just said we were going to redo it. Sure enough, there's Brian's Seas. Terrible for me. I hate going second with this army. It's not built to do that. So I just scouted the heck out of my Rhino to get him way back over there behind the crate, so that the Dracosians are at least going to have to come after it, because I know they do have to come into my zone sometime to try to get those two scoring units in here for 2 points each. But Korax by himself is going to get shot at a little bit. That's okay. I think he'll be fine. He's got cover, chameleon line, all kinds of fun stuff. And actually, no chameleon line. I'm sorry. I couldn't put chameleon on him because he's a jump troop. Thank you, army builder. Anyway, we're gonna move into this top of turn one. Brian's going to see what he can do, and then I'll try to counter-strike in the bottom of turn one. I hate that jazz. All right, top of turn one. Brian's two Dracosians move forward, and the one shimmied sideways just enough so he can take a pot shot at my Rhino, but I made my cover save behind the crate. The other one could draw a line of fire to that one Marine right there, and it actually scattered back onto the whole squad. Now, we had to look up and discuss how blast weapons work with models out of line of sight and scattering on them. Basically, scattered hit five guys. I had to take five wounds off the closest model, even though they were the guys in cover. My four up cover save, I only made one. So I lost four Marines from that squad. Did make my lookout serve for the sergeant, though, so he's okay. They're going to get to jump around next turn and do something else. Korax took a hit from the Infernus, which is just in range. AP 2 and Poison 2 plus is a good way to take out a Primarch. But he's down to 5. And that was it. So I'm going to take my bottom of turn 2, turn 1, excuse me, coming up in just a second. Bottom of turn 2, I got my Deathstorm drop pod in. It's scattered. I wanted it right here to be able to shoot both of the Dracosians, but it's scattered this way. So I managed to shoot all the super heavies. I got a lot of shots off with this. I rolled a three with all the Dracosians and the Malkadors. I managed to blow off the Demolisher Cannon and shake that tank, which is pretty cool. Brian made a bunch of cover saves. I got a lot of penetrating and glancing hits on the super heavies. He made his cover saves. He didn't get anything on him. And I did one hell point on the Valdor. The Plasma Gunners and the Bolt Pistol and the Combi Bolters for the Drop Pod. So got a swath of the Las Guns, but they're good to go with their leadership check. Korax and his buddies just are running up and hiding behind the building, getting ready to jump over and assault next turn. And the Rhino came around here, popped smoke. The Scorpius tried to drop its barrage right here. Oops, but because I couldn't see, it just scattered way off the table, and I got nothing with it. That's it. Bottom of turn one. Still no major casualties. That was a pretty good shot, though. I'm glad I got that. Moving into turn two. Brian has no reserves and no more night fighting. Top of turn two was pretty bad for me. My drop pod and most of the plasma squad got taken out by the Malkador and the Valdor. The Valdor's big gun, though, failed to actually hit anything. It was pretty funny. But the captain got killed by Demolisher Cannon because he could still target my sergeant that I left right there. The drop pod lost his weapon system. That's not cool. Over here, the Infernus killed all the assault marines in Korax's squad. I did that on purpose. I wanted to get him there and then soak all the wounds up with them so he would be stuck with 5 still and be in range to still charge something. And then now everything else over here had to snap fire at him. So the Vindicator didn't do anything. The storm section right there had to snap fire at him. No wounds caused to Korax. Now he's going to get in there and really wreck some face. But otherwise, that was pretty brutal. I lost the pod. I lost most of the plasma squad. That's drop pod is neutered. Those guys are still good, though. Nothing happened to the Rhino. So the guys in there are ready to jump out and blow something up, too. let's just see what I feel like blowing up this turn. Moving into bottom of turn two, I have two more drop pods and a Xiphon to come in from reserve. All right, this game is really engaging now. My drop pod came down here, and the Tactical Marines shot out. This is the best luck I ever have with Tactical Marines. I put a wound on the Lord Commander and killed seven of the guys in the Power Axe section. That's nuts. That's really, really good for them. That was, lots and lots of failed saves on that. Over here, the more Dathan got out, I used six of the Melta Guns to blow up the Dracosian right here, and then a couple of the guys get killed by the Whirlwind. Actually rolled triple ones hitting six guys, so they only lost three guys from the Whirlwind, and then a few more from the Explosion, I think, or one more. Yeah, one more guy from the Explosion, so six left. This Dracosian took a lot of shots from the Xiphon to bring down, and then finally the Whirlwind glancing it on the back, or on the side anyway, from the Barrage, to finish it off. So those guys emergency disembark. Drop pod did nothing. My lone plasma gunner is cowering here in Brian's deployment zone, and he's scoring, so that's a plus. And then Korax charged in and did 5 of 6 hull points to the Infernus. Of course, it's a super heavy vehicle. It is still good to go because it doesn't care about blind. That's terrible. Should have been a lot better, but oh well, it is what it is. We're going to move into the top of turn three. I'm blunting Brian's offensive, but I'm still in trouble. So top of three coming up. Oh, my other Deathstorm pod did not come in, by the way. So my frag pod is still just chilling. All right, so the bottom of turn, top of turn three was kind of weird, just to say the least. The Laz rifle section jumped up on top of the crates and killed my plasma gunner. So he was a scoring unit sitting in there. He died. The Infernus managed to torch me. I think eight of the Mordathan, and Korax made his save. Failed to do anything to the Rhino? Did we even roll on the Rhino?
It ran 1 inch.
No. Your flamer on the Rhino. I think we hit the Rhino. We'll resolve that afterward, and we'll come back at the top of the turn. These guys just ran forward an inch. Those guys moved backward and shot and killed another one of my Mordathan. The Tactical Marines got pummeled by... It's going to pen the Rhino. It's going to be... They got pummeled by the Malkador. They went to ground but made some saves.
Armor Bane.
Oh, yeah, three. That's all you get. All right, so it's going to be shaken. That's okay. No, I'm sorry. Stunned because AP2. The drop pod's down to a single hull point with no gun left. Again, thanks to the Valdor and scattering battle cannon hit. What else? Notice the Infernus is gone. The Vindicator Siege Shell from the Malkador scattered back big time and landed just nicking the corner of the Infernus. Failed the cover save. I rolled a 2 on the on my penetration roll, but since I was hitting the side, that's all I needed. And it glanced it to death, and it blew up. It scattered 12 inches almost directly at Korax, but only managed to clip him with the outer edge of the blast. We were, like, really nervous. I was really nervous. But now Korax is kind of free to do something else. Brian rolled from Assad's special reserve rule, and when the first unit that's destroyed is removed from the table, you roll a die on a 5 or 6. It can come back from ongoing reserves, but he rolled a 1. So it's like the first time he's ever used that guy that it didn't work for him, and I couldn't be happier, frankly, because I don't want to have to deal with that thing again. So my Marines right there have gone to ground. They're not in terrible shape, because I might be able to get Korax over here to deal with that Malkador. I don't know. My Xiphon is jinking because of the last cannon from the Valdor had to snap fire at him, and he actually hit it. But that's about it. So I got to keep these guys from scoring, because that is the mission. So I might just pull Korax back and try to do that. I'm not sure. I got a lot of thinking to do. I got a Deathbin drop pod that still has a chance to come in this turn, though. So we're going to move on to the bottom of turn three. Deathbin drop pods, man. They giveth and they taketh away. So my frag pod came in, did nothing to the last squad, which stank. Killed all but the commander right here, which was pretty good. Killed the last three axe dudes. Put a couple hits on the rapiers, but no wounds. And then killed 4 of my Marines, and the last guy broke and is running back this way into cover. Terrible. The Mordathan jumped back in the Rhino, and they snap-fired, and it managed to kill one of the Storm Section guys here. I killed a couple with the artillery pieces, and snap-fired the Xiphon at the Malkador and did 3 hull points with just snap fires from the Laz Cannon and the Rotary Missile Launcher, actually getting a pen and rolling a 6 on it. On that Laz Cannon, cannon shot, though. I rolled trip sixes on my barrage and managed to take a big chunk out of the storm section. So those guys are down to five guys, and Korax killed the section here and is hunting them down. I'm going to keep Brian pinned back in his zone so he doesn't score any points for the mission and hope that I can actually get a few myself. But it's not looking pretty. I only have two scoring unit models left, not counting the Rhino, which does score in the Adepticon mission as long as it's within 3 inches of the actual squad it's from. So Brian's going to try to kill all these guys individually and then try to get me on just on attrition points, because I sincerely doubt he's going to be able to kill Korax. I got to try to kill that dude to get Warlord. It's looking ugly. So, yep. Top of four coming up.
Top of turn four. It's getting interesting. Brian's starting to try to take out some of my denial units because they actually do score in this mission. That drop pod is wrecked, and the other one got blown up by the Valdor finally doing something. Yay, he killed two drop pods this game.
35 points.
70 points total for that tank. That's awesome.
With a commander.
Yep, these guys shuffle forward here. They're trying to get at least remotely close to being able to score. They got to get over here. They're a long way away still. These guys, again, also shuffle forward, but they're not there yet. Let's see. That was about it. Really, all that happened is you're starting to clean up your zone. Oh, yeah, the Rhino got blown up. Yep, that's right, because I couldn't make cover saves from the multi-laser. On your Malkador blew that thing up. That was pretty good. So the guy got out, though, and he's hiding on the other side of that hemotrope reactor, but I believe he's actually in the deployment zone right now. So he might be good to go, and it might be really hard to move him. He is scoring.
This is denying.
That is denying, so that's a total of 3 points for me right now. But we're not done yet. So we're going to move into the bottom of turn four.
Bottom of turn four, the Scorpius killed four of the five guys running this way. Korax shot at the sergeant, hit with both his pistols and rolled double ones, and then made a 12-inch charge to come finish him off, consolidated back this way. So there's no more scoring units anywhere for Brian on that half the table. They're in threatening, Korax is actually threatening them. I got to roll as it will not die in a minute. My more deafened guy kind of just tucked himself in here to hide. The drop pod couldn't do anything. It's got no weapon. And the Zyphon managed to take out one entire rapier team, and it's going to have to kind of try to not fly off the board next turn. Yeah, it's going to have to try to not fly off the table in turn five. They made their leadership check. Otherwise, everything's good to go. So we're going to move into the top of turn five. This game is getting sticky. Korax, the only thing I really have is Korax jumping forward and charging the las rifles and wiping them out to a man. The Zyphon flew off the table, and the Scorpius tried to drop some shots on the Malkador to make it easier to blow him up next turn, and I failed, or the Valdor, excuse me. Failed to hit it, scattered completely off. Brian's turn before that, though, he did manage to blow up drop pods. And take another wound off of Korax, which I got to roll will not die again. And that was it. So that was turn five. We did roll turn six. It's coming up. It's going to be very quick, though. All right, that was turn six. Oh, turn six was terrible for me. I lost like four wounds on Korax from just everything shooting at him and me rolling lots of ones. The Valdor got into my deployment zone, so he is now denying some points right there. So it's got a point, and Brian has me in attrition. But I did manage to kill Warlord over here with Korax, but he's down on one wound, and I hope that thing can't get close enough to shoot, and it probably will, so I'm probably going to lose Korax. Excuse me, unless I get really, really lucky. So we're going to go into turn seven, unfortunately. Yuck, not happy. All right, here we are after turn seven. The only thing that mattered was the Malkador failed to kill Korax. He hit him with a bunch of stuff. I kept making saves. Hit him with a Vindicator shell, which was the big one. And he rolled a one to wound. Oh, it was epic. So my turn, Korax just runs and hides back here. He's not going to do anything stupid. Because it's not worth it. I can't get attrition. Brian's got me big time in points there. I have Warlord and one denial unit because my flyer does not count as a denial unit. He's in the air. And everything else is destroyed except for the Valdor, who is a denial unit, and the Malkador, who is kind of beat up. So if we had like nine turns, maybe I'd fly off and come back and blow him up or something dumb like that. But that's it. One, two, three, four, five units total left on the table and a 2-2 draw. Insane. So it's my first time taking on Brian's Solar Ox. It was nasty. Nasty, nasty, nasty. He's got some quad mortars that might help the list a little bit.
Instead of the axes.
Yeah, instead of the axes. It probably will help get a lot more shots. Seizing the initiative against me is makes me angry, because when you build an Alpha Strike army, you want to go first, and when you can't, it just really, really hurts. So I had to like play catch up, it felt like, the whole game, and finally, towards the end, I thought I was, and then A draw. I'll take a draw. That was a really hard-fought game. I'm sweating. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and hopefully we get a couple more games before Adepticon, and we'll see some different lists that some of the other guys are going to bring to it. We got at least four guys from our club who are going to be at Adepticon playing in the Heresy event, so it's pretty cool. Thanks for watching.